Hey again, math class. Okay, so one more thing that is kind of new and different about dividing decimals that might be a bit of a challenge to kind of get used to is the fact that if I have a whole number, say, and I wanted to, I could add a decimal point to it. I mean, obviously it has a decimal point. The decimal point always lives right after it. But I could add it even if it wasn't there to begin with. So if I have a whole number 7 or 17 or 417 or whatever, and I want to, I can add a decimal point and a zero. And in fact, I could add as many zeros behind it as I wanted. Another thing, too, is if you already have a decimal point and some numbers behind it, and you, again, too, you wanted to add zeros, that's okay, too. Remember, these are what we would term unnecessary zeros, but they can help out in division problems, as you'll see. And they're most likely going to happen, and you're going to be using them in two situations, when you're dividing a smaller number by a larger number, or when you encounter a remainder, okay? So this is something that hasn't really been talked about in any of the other videos, so let's look at some examples. Okay, here is 40 divided into 20, okay? Or 20 divided by 40. And you might be saying to yourself, wait a minute, I can't do that. 20 is smaller than 40. How does that work? Well, we get around that by adding a decimal point and a zero, okay? So, just like in all the other problems that we've seen, I can do this as long as I bring up the decimal point, and then it's like I'm going to ignore that one underneath there and treat it like it's 400 into 200. I can do that, or 40 into 200. I can do that problem, right? 40 into 200. Even though it started as this, with a decimal point there, we're ignoring it, and we're just going to go into 200. Okay, how many times can 40 go into 200? 40 times 2 is 80. 40 times 3, 120, right? 40 times 4, 160. 40 times 5, up, there it is right there. So 40 can go into 200. 5 times, which is 200. So, I can divide a bigger number into a smaller number simply by adding a decimal point, a zero. And as long as I bring the decimal point up, I'm going to treat this under the bracket like it was a whole number. Okay? Let's look at another example. Here I've got some decimals already started, okay? I've already got decimals in place here. So 3/10 divided into 2/10. So again, you're going to hopefully be saying like, oh, wait a minute, I can't do that. You know, that doesn't work. That doesn't work. So here we go. I'm going to move my decimal point, because I guarantee you that we can do this. I'm going to bring it straight up, and I'm going to add a zero, because remember, I can add a zero to anything after I've got my decimal point there. Okay, so now here my problem becomes basically 3 into 20, right? I can do that. How many times can 3 go into 20? It can go 6 times, right? 6 times 3, 18. I have 2 left over. Now, I still have some left over here. This is sort of our remainder problem, too. I'm just going to add another zero and bring it down. So, 3, can it go into 20? Yeah, it goes 6 times, which is 18. I have 2 left over. Do you see what's happening? I could just keep adding zeros on forever. But I'm going to keep getting 20 down here, right? I'm going to keep getting 20. So at this point, I'm going to go and draw a line over the sixes like that. And I'm going to say that 0.2 divided by 0.3, or 2/10 divided by 3/10, actually equals 66/100, or 0.66 repeating. That's what this guy means. This means repeat. Like it goes on and on forever. Okay? Let's look at some more of these where we just keep adding zeros, okay? Here is an example. It's We're going back to whole numbers again, just because it's kind of a nice place to start. So I have 6, and I'm dividing that into 85, okay? Can 6 go into 85? Yes, it can. Let me grab my piece of paper here. 6 can go into 8 one time. I have 6 left over. 8 minus 6 is 2. I'm going to drop the 5. 6 can go into 25 4 times. 24. I have 1 left over. I'm going to add a decimal point and a 0. Bring my decimal point straight up. And so then now I can drop this 0 down. Can 6 go into 10? Yes, it can. It's going to go in one time, which is 6. Whoop. I have 4 left over. I'm going to drop in another 0 because, again, I can just keep going. Can 6 go into 40? Yes, it can. It can go 5 times. 6 times 5 is 30. Oh, we can go more than that, can't we? 6 times 6, 36. I'm running out of room here. I have 4 left over. Do you see what's happening? I've got one of those repeating numbers again. I can put 6 times 6, and which is 36. I'm going to have 4 left over. So again, at this point, I'm going to go like that because I'm going to draw a line over that 6 because I'm just going to have 6s forever, okay? So I could say that 85 divided by 6 is actually 14.166 repeating. Okay? Let's look at one more example. I know this is really, really trippy, but we are going to practice this in class, so don't worry. And we'll have lots of time to do this because I don't want to rush through this. It's an important skill to kind of know. Okay, can 3 go into 13? Yes, it can. It can go 4 times, right? 4 times 3 is 12. I have 1 left over. I have this like remainder situation here, so I'm going to drop in a decimal point and add a 0. Bring my 0 down. Can 3 go into 10? Yes, it can. It goes 3 times. I have 1 left over. Still have a remainder. So I'm going to drop in another 0, drop it down. Can 3 go into 10? Yes, it can. 3 times 3 is 9. I have 1 left over. Still have a remainder. I'm going to add another 0 up here. Drop it down. Can 3 go into 10? Yes, it can. 3 times. 3 times 3 is 9. Do you see what's happening? I have yet another situation of a repeating number. It's not always going to do this. All of the examples, I've picked some crummy examples, apparently, because they all are coming out to be these repeating numbers. Sometimes, though, you'll go 3 or 4 places out, and you'll actually hit a 0 down here. Some of the problems that I give you in class, I'll try to make them that way. So I think a good rule of thumb is to go out 4 places and then to, like, round to the nearest third place, you know, if it feels like it's not going to ever end. Or if it's the same number that's not ever going to end, if you just draw the line above it after you've gone out 3 or 4 places, I think that would be good. So anyway, that's an important thing to remember, that you can add a decimal point and zeros, as many of these like unnecessary zeros as you want, to sort of keep solving your dividing decimal problem, okay?